is it business wholly and exclusively incurred for business ataupun ada personal, kan? Then not net profit. So for tax, kita mula dengan mana? Kita mula dengan kena ada nama lah. Ye assessment. Okay. So kita ada few things. Ini items. So we will gonna have one column. Can one column ni systematic lah. On the notes. So kita tahu whether we have considered notes tidak. Systematic lah, step by step. Otherwise, we forget the notes, kita pun tak tahu macam merebahkan mana. Right. And then we gonna have something on the adding part. Kalau kita nak add balik. And mungkin juga kita keboleh, ya, yang mana kita tolak. Okay. So that's how it works. So kita tengok pula dalam each one. Kan, each of the item. Tapi for tax kita kata we start with net income. Sebab kali ni dia ada net income. Net income dia berapa? 130 900. So 130 900. So that's a starting point. Since ini datang daripada soalan, markah mungkin ada, markah mungkin tak ada. Very simple. Cuma tak suka pun tak tahu. Dah beritahu dah, bicara beritahu dah. Ada markah kalau dah dikesian. Tak ada markah kalau dia tak kesian. Sebab very straightforward. Ambil letak je. Macam pekerja lah kan. Ambil letak je. Bagilah RM2. Kalau dia kena ambil letak batu bata lagi apa semua tu, barulah bagi dia lebih lah kan. So we start with net profit. Very straightforward. Lepas tu kita kena ada income kita add or minus. So kita less ada income. Yang pertama apa? Rental. So here we add, here we less. Rental berapa? 10,000. Note berapa? Note number berapa? That's the reason why I put here. So you know, you already considered number one. Kan? Bolehlah cacah merbah. Tapi orang yang buat cacah merbah ni, saya tahu dah, after 40 years. Memang tak berjaya. Nak berjaya, must be systematic. And kita ngajar how to be systematic. Kan? So renter, although it says that the renter received was from a house owned by Maisara in Milai. Add or minus? Add or deduct? Why add?
Own personal.
Kita kan semua nak less kan, ada income kan. Ada income kita add ke minus?
Minus.
Usnah tadi cakap dah. So whatever pun, kita less dulu. Ini less, ini add. Note 1, ada income. Apa lagi ada income? Gain. Gain ni ada notes ke? Tak ada. How much? 1,000. Note ni dia boleh buat cerita-cerita pun boleh, boleh apalah, to confuse pun boleh. Kan? To make macam nampak macam add ke minus ke boleh juga. Tapi we want to understand, tak ada masalah. And then the next other income is commission. Come on, commission. ada income juga. Okay. But there is a note. Tulis note dulu. So bila dah tulis note, when you write the note, you must read the note and see why there's a note. Itulah kata the bulb must become blur. The bulb must light up. Apa dia kata the commission ni? The commission was received from one of her suppliers due to high volumes of sales in the year 2020. Kenapa they receive commission?
High volume.
So is this part of the business income ataupun yes, not part of the business income?
Part of business.
So kalau part of business income, perlu tak kita less? Tak. Okay, logik macam tu tak apa. Let me say nil. Because that is taxable, right? Taxable income, right? It's part of the business. You, walaupun you consider as commission outside the real business, tapi it's part of the business. Okay. Ada lagi other income? Tak ada. So you less other income, then you add apa? Non allowable kan, then you add back lah. Ikut notes. Kan tak? Follow the notes. Nak lompat pun tak tahu lah mana yang lompat. Lompat tu yang silap. Since kita dah ada 1, 2, the next should be 3. What is 3? Salaries and EPF. Salaries and EPF. Note 3. Dan baca lah note 3. Ada tak all for business ataupun for ni? What is note 3 dia cakap apa? Mai Saram yang gaji berapa? 18,000. EPF 2,000. Kan? Lepas tu Razlan, dia tak cerita who's Razlan? Worker ke apa ke, tak apalah. Kan? Mungkin worker lah kot. Kita andai macam tu lah. Kan? As an employee. 15,600, 3,003. Okay? CT. CT ni disable. Kan? Worker. So 8,000. EPF 1,900. Okay. Now kita ambil the first one. Mai Sarah. Mai Sarah. Add or minus or tak buat apa? Add, minus or tak buat apa? Mana nil? Kalau add, why add? Sebab ustaz apa? Dia owner and then dia dapat gaji. Kan? So kita mesti add. Logic thinking lah. Okay. Banyak akli sikit. Okay. Logicalnya kata personal tak boleh. Razlan. Then you have Razlan. Note 3 juga. So note ni kena go on because dia adalah ABC. Cuma dia tak tulis ABC. Ya. Kalau 3A, 3B, 3C boleh juga. Razlan ni macam mana? Add or minus?
Minus.
Why minus? Dia employee. So boleh kita tolak balik. When you tolak di sini balik, apa maksud dia? Apa maksud dia? Gaji dia 15,600. Is it allowed for business?
Allowed.
Employee?
Allowed.
Allowed. Ini add back apa?
Non-allowable.
Kan? So what is non-allowable? Razlan ni allowed ke not allowed?
Allowed.
Allowed. So add ke minus ke tak buat apa?
Tak buat apa. Ni.
Tak buat apa. Maknanya dia dah tolak dah dekat tu kan? Dia dah tolak dah income statement. Kita ambil the income, net income. Kita adjust this. Maksudnya, ini dah bersih ke tak bersih? Dah bersih, right? Net di sini. How to get this net adalah selepas? Dah tolak lah. From accounting side lah. Kita cuma nak go through each one. Is this allowable? Not allowable. Allowable, not allowable. This is from tax point of view because it is the law say so. Bukan accounting say so. And then kita ada soalan lagi. Siti. Kan? Siti macam mana? Tapi dia disabled, right? Disabled ni dapat tak? Special deduction.
Dapat.
How many times? Two times. So kalau sekali dah dapat dah. So kat sini macam mana? Kita nak tolak berapa? Dia gaji RM8,000, right? So sini kita nak tolak. Tolak berapa? How many thousand? Or blank, or blur. How many thousand? Boleh tolak ke tak boleh tolak? Allowable, not allowable? Bila non allowable, that's why kita ada dua ruang ni. Bila kita add, apa maksudnya? Allowable ke non allowable ni? Huh? Not allowable. That's why kita add back to here. Bila kita ada sini, apa maksudnya? Allowable. Ataupun kita adjust ni kemudian lah. Kan? Because it's not the business source itself. Kalau capital allowance, sekarang tadi kata, capital allowance must from the business source. That source. Kalau your investment account apa semua tu, bukan yang the source, it's a different source. Source tu very important. Source of income. So sekarang Siti ni, allowable tak? Boleh tolak tak gaji dia? Tak boleh. Sebab?
Disabled.
Ha? Disabled. Nanya.
Dah
lah, dia orang tercacat. Lepas tu, you bayar gaji. Pada you cakap dengan majikan, logik tak logik? Then you tell the majikan, you punya gaji you bayar kat orang OKU, not allowable. Mampu tak mampu? Kalau saya jumpa Anwar, saya baling telur busuk kat dia. You bloody idiot prime minister. Okay. I got an OKU. You only need to take an OKU. And after that, you don't allow me to deduct from my expenses. Logik ke tak logik? It's crazy. Anwar pun akan lari balik. Who teach a text for you pula? We encourage, just like you say, we encourage the companies to take OKU. Tapi when you pay them, mana you already deduct once in your income statement. Betul tak? But because the government encourage you to take it, so you can deduct how many times?
Two.
Berapa kali?
Two.
Two times. Dan sekali you dah deduct ke mana?
Income,
income statement dah habis dah. So sekali lagi you can deduct sini?
8,000 lah.
Logic and then think why. But jangan cakap tak boleh tidak. Okay. Then company nak ambil OKU, then you kata no, you cannot tidak. Why? Habis lah nanti. That is salary. Bawa salary. Lepas tu ada apa? My punya EPF. Razlan punya EPF. Siti punya EPF. Tadi kita tengok EPF ni apa? Limitation dia 19%. You can pay how many. That's why we'll go back, baca nota tu. Bukan sekali tak faham, baca lagi dua kali, tak baca lagi tiga kali, ni empat kali, sebelum tidur pun lima kali. Whatever lah, until you understand. Can? So EPF nya tu berapa? Mai Sara?
2000.
Allowable or not allowable? So not allowable. It doesn't matter the limitation of 19% ke apa. Sebab apa not allowable? Because she is the so how much can I add back?
2000.
Personal sendiri you boss, Tauke, Khairul Amin, not allowable. Not allowable. Very simple, very simple. Now Razlan pula, he's a worker. Berapa dia punya EPF? Allowable, not allowable. Kita tahu lagi sebab kita kena use the what is the limit?
19%
of what?
Employee remuneration.
Berapa salary dia? Salary dia berapa?
15,000.
Bukan the EPF. The 90% is on the salary kan? Mana boleh datang EPF dulu? Then you tengok limit is 90%. Berapa? How much? 2,964. So the limit is actually only 2,964 because 90%, 2,964. You can give 100,000, 20,000, doesn't matter. Tapi the limit is 90% of the salary, which is 2,964. Sekarang ni Mai Sarah bayar dia berapa? So apa macam mana kita nak buat sekarang ni? Macam mana kita nak faham? Macam mana kita nak faham? Kita mungkin 1 minit, then you go back and then you do the others. And soalan nombor 2, buat masuk balik dalam goals. So macam mana kita nak faham? The limit is 2,964. Dia dah bayar 3,003. Dia dah terlebih bayar ataupun kurang bayar?
Terlebih
bayar. So now we add or we deduct or we don't do anything. Terlebih bayar berapa? How much?
336.
The limit is only 2,964. You already given him 3,300. So the difference is 336. Add, tolak, or nothing?
Tolak.
Husna?
Tolak.
Add. Why? What's the logic? 2,964 is the limit 90%. Betul? 2,003. Now there's a difference of 336. Tidak. Tidak. Add back or nil? No adjustment.
Tidak.
Siapa cakap add? Why? Add ke tak? The limit is 2,964. Tapi you dah bayar 330. So you already give him more by? Kena cukai balik lah. Non-allowable. The word is non-allowable. Non-allowable. The word is non-allowable. Bayarlah berapa banyak you nak. But the tax says not allowed. When you not allowed, you add back. Khairul Amin nak bayar, apa-apa bayar, bayarlah. And come back tax, you say hello. Add back your income. Otherwise, ngomong ke no revenue. I repeat that. Semalam saya repeat banyak kali. If what industry wants is doesn't match with the government revenue, I agree. The government revenue must be protected. Janganlah pergi tipu, janganlah ada curi, janganlah ada rasuah. I agree with that. Industri pun janganlah bagi rasuah kepada pon. Yang bagi rasuah ni industri. Dia tak mau cakap. City, kita stop dekat city pula. City berapa? 1,900. How do you care about that now? 90% off? 8,000. So 8,000 times 19%, berapa? 1,520. Itu limit. Tidak? How much did they pay? How much my Sarah pay? So 1,900 they pay. Kurang ke lebih? By how much? 380. Add or deduct or no adjustment? Alhamdulillah. So kita dah habis waktu, kan? Then kita jumpa balik. Continue balik with all that alasan-alasan dan sebagainya, so that kita boleh soalan dua buat and masukkan dalam sistem by Monday night, kan? Monday night 11:59, and then kita boleh bincang next week dan tengok jugalah yang ni. Okay, kita berhenti di sini. Okay, yang kata tadi KMC 1 yang ada dalam kelas ni yang saya tak catat lagi, please come forward.